Hello, hello, hello. Well, I first would like to say my name is Kawana Brickhouse. Yes, yes, yes. And I have a mission here on this earth for life, y'all. That mission is EIC. That is Elevate, Inspire, and Create. Woo, woo. Elevating who? You to that next level so that you are inspired to create your own world. That is totally my mission, my mandate here on earth for life. Look, I'm having a midnight session with you all. You know, it's actually being recorded at in the evening, late at night, early in the morning, I guess you would say. And the topic for tonight, or wee hours in the morning, is Queen's Foundation. Queen's Foundation. So, you know, this is a, do y'all like my backdrop? I first would like to say, do y'all like my backdrop? It's a castle. We're in the palace, okay? We're talking about the queens. Yes, because I'm a queen. And any of the ladies in the atmosphere, any of the ladies watching the video, any of, might I say, call you queens that are watching the video. Yes, yes, yes. Hey, I welcome you in. Come on in. Sit down. Take you a seat. Get out your cup of tea. We are about to have some QT quality queen time. Yes, we are sitting at the table. Yes, it's time. It's time, right? It's been time. I got some things in store for you all. Queens. Yes, for the queens. Some things that's coming down the pipeline. So, but before we get to anything about the coming down the pipeline, I want to go ahead and get to the message for tonight. And so the message for tonight, as I was saying before, it's called the Queen's Foundation. Huh? Yes. Yes. The Queen's Foundation. And my reasons for choosing to name this video, this segment, Queen's Foundation, is because every woman, just as well as every male, man as well, you know, queen or king, we have to have a foundation. And where does our foundation come from? Where does your foundation come from? Our foundation comes from the King of Kings, right? Yes, he granted us, the King of Kings, granted you and I, queens, to be queens for his glory, right? But our foundation of who we are and what we stand for comes from the Lord. Yes, comes from the Lord. And I want to base that foundation, I want to take you to a scripture in the book of 1 Peter 2 and 9. One of my favorites, actually. I actually talk about this scripture in my book, Who Are You? I Discovered Me from a Girl to a Queen. If you have not purchased the book, I encourage you to contact me, email me, reach out to me. In the detailed description of this video, you're able to be able to contact me so that you could purchase the book. You could actually go online and purchase it. You could purchase it. It can be purchased on Amazon as well as Barnes and Nobles. Or you can contact me if you're local in the Norfolk area. Okay, so with that being said, I want to go ahead, y'all, let's go, queens, as well as kings, because, hey, this message could bless the kings as well, right? No, that's not the scripture I'm trying to get to. What I thought I was just at. Y'all, it keep kind of like blanking out. I ain't going away. I'm still here. Okay, so 1 Peter, let me move my little self. Move my little self closer. So that it won't blink out like it did. 1 Peter 2 and 9 says, but you are a chosen people. Yes. Huh. A royal priesthood. Yes. A holy nation. Yes. A people belonging to God, that you may declare the praises of Him who called you what? The Lord, Jesus Christ, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. He called you out of darkness. That's why your foundation comes from Him, because He pulled you up out of that darkness. He pulled you up out of the miry clay. He went to hell, to Hades, to get the keys for us, to give us a solid foundation, right? He called you out of darkness into His what? His marvelous light. That's what the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, our mighty counselor, our Prince of Peace, did for us, queens. He called us up out of darkness into the marvelous light. He gave us a solid foundation in Him. He said, no more do you have to struggle. No more do you have to cry, weep, settle for less. Look, I have chosen you from the foundations of this earth. God said, the Lord Jesus Christ said, He chose who? You and I, queen. Yes, as well as the kings. But He chose us. Chose us. He chose us as His children, as His kings and queens here on this earth. We're here. We're allowed to reign here on this earth. We're allowed to do His will and fulfill His purpose here on this earth. We were chosen. Yes, we have been granted a royal priesthood. He said, not only have I granted you a royal priesthood, but I've granted you to be able to receive a holy nation. Yes, a people. God said, you are my people. Yes. That what belong to Him. So that's why your foundation comes from the Lord, because He chose you. He created you for such a time as it is. And I know y'all probably wondering, are we going to talk a little bit about Queen Esther? Yeah, we're going to get into Queen Esther too. But to all my queens, look, I want you to know that God have chosen you. Your foundation comes from Christ. And my reasons for even bringing that up is because the other day, right, I was leaving work, okay? Had a long day. And I had my teacup. Y'all see this teacup? Oh, gosh. I had my teacup with me, right? This teacup. I purchased two of them. One for me and one for my daughter, my oldest daughter. And because right now the oldest one can truly appreciate it. So I had my teacup, and it originally had a handle on it, right? Originally. If you notice, the handle is broken, right? So I got in a car. Well, I was putting my things in a car, and I set the teacup on top of the car. Long day. I think I was on the phone. I was having a conversation, and I'm driving off, like, ready to go home, right? And guess what happened, y'all? I heard a boom. Like, what's that noise? Guess what it was? My teacup. I had forgot to put it in the car. I had forgot to take it off of the top of the car and bring it in and put it in my little cup holder. So I get out the car, stop the car immediately, right? And I look on the ground, and I'm like, oh my God. You're just being very dramatic. That's just who I am, right? My cup is broken. So I'm looking, and I'm thinking the whole cup is shattered. The whole cup is shattered. But thank God, guess what? I still had what? I still had the base of the cup, but the handle was gone. The handle was missing. You know? I think I even kept the lid, but the handle was broken. And as I was driving off, I was getting this revelation. And immediately out of my mouth, because y'all know me, those who've been watching my videos, those who come in, you'll get to know me soon. But I get revelations from the Lord all the time, from the silliest things that happen or the deepest things or the weirdest things. I get revelations from him. God speaks to me through revelations, through things that, you know, that happens in my life. It helps me to grow, you know, to develop, to get stronger. And so I'm looking at my cup and I'm like, man, and I'm still on the phone. I'm like, oh my gosh, I broke my cup. I'm gonna have to get me a new one. But then I was like, Lord, what are you teaching me about this cup right here, right now? And I it just hit me just like that. Bam. It was just like that. Bam. It hit me. Look, guess what, Kawana? Guess what? That cup dropped, right? And your commotion and the moving and about and going about your day, doing what you need to do after long days of work, your cup dropped. But guess what? The whole thing did not break. I want you to know that your foundation as a queen is solid in me. He was letting me know, Kawana, you solid in me. You solid in me. I am your foundation. So guess what? You might go through some situations. Some storms may arise. Some problems may happen. You may cut up here, cut up there, go through this, feel like a failure in this and feel like a failure in that. But I want you to know, because your foundation, because I chose you from the foundations of this earth, according to 1 Peter 2:9, because you are what? A royal priesthood, a holy nation. What? Let me go back a little. You are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, brought out of darkness into the marvel. You may go through some dark times. You may go through some valleys, but your foundation, baby, it's in me. So guess what? Whether the storms come, whether hail or tsunamis or whatever take place, know that you are solid in me. You may have some arms break off. Come on now. Some arms may break off. Huh? You might even lose a limb here or there, but your foundation, your core is in me. So just stay in me. I got you. Stay in me. I will lead you. Stay in me. I will never leave you nor forsake you. That's what the Lord was letting me know. Baby, your foundation is in me. You're still a queen. Yes. Yes, you broke something off. Something happened. You got a little limp, but your foundation is still in me. So trust me through the process. Trust me through the storm. So queens, I'm telling you, trust the Lord. And then there comes a times where God is saying, look, you trust me, trust in him, right? But guess what? I'm going to link you up with some other queens, right? And you're going to lock arms with other queens. And y'all, because y'all foundation is in him, you're going to be able to what? Keep moving. Keep pressing. Guess what? And you're going to have queens, other queens that's by your side. Other queens that, hey, may have been through what you've been through, gonna be able to lend a helping hand and gonna be able to say, hey, you know what? I got your back. I got your back. I'ma grant you a new crown. Hey, I'ma help you out. Look, I'ma replenish what just took place, my sister. I got your back. Look, you're not alone. Okay, you was limping, but I'm here to help you because my daddy, who's your daddy? He's allowing us to lock arms and he's wanting me to let you know that you're not alone. Look, I'm willing to sow seed into your life. I'm willing to fast and pray and intercede with you to see that breakthrough take place, you know? And so I thought about when I was going to go ahead and do this video, I contact who? Who did I have to contact? My girl, my baby girl, my oldest one. Neat, right? Because originally when I bought the cups, I bought them together, right? I bought them together. And they both were brand new cups. Had no idea that I would encounter what I encountered and that my cup would break, but the foundation was still there. Look, but God was letting me know, look, you can lock arms with your daughter. Contact her. Get the cup so that you can do the video. She has hers, right? Yeah, she got strength when you may feel weak at moments. Guess what? She know how to pray a prayer if you down and out. Look, you may be in the bed sick, but she's willing to come over there and sacrifice and help you at times or in needs. Look, you're not alone. Look, not only do you have your foundation in Christ, but I have placed with you. That's what God is saying. I've placed in your life. Look, dear sisters and brothers of Christ that are going to come along, Kawana, with you. And it's going to help you on this journey, right? People who done been there and done that, right? Some of them have and some of them haven't, but that's all right. The key is coming together as one. Look, queens, we got to come together. Look, we got to trust. Number one in him, but trust that God is going to place the right queens around us that are trustworthy, that we can confide in, that will pray with us, that will have our back in the times of need. You know what I'm saying? I also want to add, let me keep the new cup right here. I also want to add that, look, when situations arise, you know, because sometimes queens go through things because of what? We go through things because of a lack of faith. We go through things because of being stubborn. How many queens out here, hey, I'm not just talking to myself, I'm talking to you too. Have you ever been stubborn in your life? Have you ever just decided to do things on your own instead of trusting the Lord through the process? So in order to keep and to develop and to allow your foundation to get even stronger in the Lord and to have what you need on the journey that you're going on, you have to be willing to die to self, right? As a queen. As a queen of the Most High, it is important that you die to self. It's important that you're freed and delivered from issues and matters of the heart. You know, filthiness, the fleshly things, you know. And I want to take you to a verse that a girlfriend blessed me with the other day. And I've heard it before, but I needed to hear it again, right? And we're going to go back again to First Peter. Yes, the book of First Peter. And this time we're going to the third chapter. And I'm going to read some of the scriptures. It says, wives in the same way. Because queens, not every queen is married. But one day, if it's your will that you desire, because God, he gives you the desires of your heart. You desire to get married or whatever. It is important that you follow these rules. That you apply these scriptures, these laws that God has given us in this Bible, and apply them to your life so that you can be the best queen, the best wife, the best mother, the best woman here on this earth. So it reads, wives, in the same way, submit. Be submissive to your husbands, so that if any of them do not believe the word, they may be won over without words by the behavior of their wives, right? It goes on and it reads, when they see the purity and the reverence of your lives, your beauty should not come from what? Look, our beauty don't come from these trinkets in my hair, the rings on the finger, the bracelets on the arm, the earrings in the ear. Some people may even have earrings in their nose. No, our beauty don't come from these frivolous things that we may see, that we adorn ourselves with, on the outside. But our true beauty, this is where it comes from. Your beauty should not come from the outward adornment, such as the braided hair. I just was talking about the hair, the wearing of the gold and the jewelry and the fine clothes. Instead, it should what? It should be that you're of an inner self. Look, a true queen that has the foundation of Christ, her beauty comes from the inner self, the unfading beauty of a what? A gentle and quiet spirit, which is of great worth in God's sight. Yes, verse 5 says, for this is the way the holy women of the past who put their hope in God used to make themselves beautiful. The holy women of the past to make themselves beautiful, they worked on the inner self. It wasn't the outer. It was the inner that mattered the most. So, go on and I'll continue to read. It says, they used to make themselves beautiful. It says, they were submissive to their own husbands, like Sarah, who obeyed Abraham, okay, and called him her master. You are her daughters if you do what is right and do not give away to fear. Look, don't be afraid to be able to be submissive, to be able to be a woman of unfaded beauty. You know what I'm saying? Let me see. The unfaded beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit. There's nothing wrong with having a gentle and quiet spirit. It doesn't make you less of a woman to have a gentle and quiet spirit. I'll go back because I have another verse I want to share. But I'm thinking about a specific queen in the book of Esther who was stubborn. Might I say that I have been stubborn in my lifetime more than once, multiple times, quite a bit? Yeah. Yes. No, not you, Kawana. Yes. Kawana, have been stubborn. I've been hard-headed, y'all. I haven't always listened to the Lord like I should, to keep myself out of the problems. Some of the problems that I've endured in life has been because of my stubbornness, have been because of me being fast, have been because of me not being patient, waiting on the Lord. So there was a queen that was on the throne before Queen Esther came along and took the crown. And that queen was Queen Vashti. And she was a woman that was stubborn. She refused to go dance for the king when he called for her. She felt like, no, I ain't doing that. I ain't your puppet. I mean, she had an attitude. Yes. And she refused to do what she was requested to do by the king. So guess what? She was bumped. Yes. And guess what happened? I'm gonna go ahead and just finish this story on up. Well, what had happened was, no, seriously, what happened? The king started to go looking for his queen again, a new queen. He needed a new queen. He needed a new queen on the throne to be by his side. So, you know, There was the word was out and all these different young women went through the process of these beauty treatments and they was picked first, and then they had to go through treatments and go through the process to be purified, to be purged, to be cleaned up, you know, in order to be this dainty, beautiful, fearless woman, you know, that's willing to be meek and mild and gentle and loving, but also bold at the right times, you have to go through purification. Well, they went through purification. They went through 6 months of purification. And one of the women that went through the purification was Esther. Yes, Esther, along with other women. And guess who was chosen? Esther. She was chosen to be queen. She was chosen at such a time. Yes. Why? Because number one, she had certain qualities. She was beautiful, you know. The king adored her, right? Evidently, she must have had what, y'all? She had to have a beauty of gentle and quiet spirit about her. She had to have respect. She had to have this meek personality. Yes, she was beautiful on the outside. Yes, I'm sure she had the jewels. But her true beauty, y'all, it came from this, what the representation in this, in the scriptures right here in 1 Peter chapter 3, talking about the adorned woman who, yes, she has the braided hair and everything, but her true beauty comes from where? The inner self. An unfaded beauty that comes from the Lord, your true foundation. I'm going to sum this all up and I'm going to bring it on in. So Queen Esther was chosen. And then not only was she chosen, but God used her and gave her favor to be able to what? Help save her people because of her meekness, her wisdom. Her foundation that came from the Lord. She obeyed God. She went on a fast. Y'all, did y'all know she went on a fast for 3 days? She didn't eat anything, and she had so much authority that she called out and said, "Hey, those who want to go, I need these people, you all to go on this fast with me. Turn down your plate, because after these 3 days, I'm gonna go before the king." How many of you need to go before the king about some things? How many of you need to turn down your plate and go before the king and trust that he's going to work out situations on your behalf? I'm going to live a witness today that just like God worked it out for Queen Esther and her people was saved, look, he'll do the same for you. He'll save your family. He'll save that daughter. He'll save your sons. He'll save your siblings. Yes, he will turn your situation around if you are willing to be a woman that's meek and mild, that's gentle. I want to end with sharing this last verse, Queens. Proverbs chapter 31. Hallelujah. Verse 30 and 31 says, charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting. But a woman who fears the Lord, guess what? She is to be praised. Verse 31 says, give her the reward she has earned and let her works bring her praise at the city gates. Did y'all hear that? Give her the reward she has earned due to her what? Her fearing the Lord, reverencing God, choosing to keep him first, making him the foundation of her life. God said in the last verse says, give her the reward she has earned and let her works bring her praise in the city gates. Look, ladies, queens, look, when you are willing to die to self and please the Lord, he will work it out. on your behalf and put you out on the forefront for all to see for his glory. He will reward you, queens. So I encourage you, just as I had a girlfriend encourage me, Kawana, be patient. Kawana, continue to allow the Lord to work on your gentle spirit. Kawana, admit where you need help at. The Lord is here to help you. I'm saying to you today, the Lord is here to help you. Look, I had to be honest. I had to be transparent with myself, with God. Yeah, I've been stubborn, Lord. I've done a lot of things in my own will and not your will. But Lord, I'm determined to get it right this time. Are you determined to get it right, Queen? I think you are. So look, make your foundation in the Lord, right? Lock arms with other great queens who can lend you a helping hand, right? And trust the process. Look, share this video with someone that may need to hear it. There's some powerful scriptures that I put in this message tonight. And most of all, look, keep smiling, queen. Keep your head up. You know, shift that crown. You can turn it to the side, to the right, to the left, whatever which way. Guess what? You look good with that crown on. Yes, the crown of a meek, humble spirit. The crown of a beautiful queen that's sent from the king above. Yes, queen, I'm encouraging you today. Walk that walk, girl. Talk that talk, girl. The Lord has a plan for you. I would like to end with a phenomenal song that I love by Miley Music called Royalty. I have no rights to the song. I just want to try to hear it out. Queens, we are royalty. Are you chosen? Glory to Christian. Hey. What? Into the marvelous one. Royal people. Are you royal? Yes. Chosen people. I love you. You are royalty, okay? Royal, royal. Royal people. God bless you. Subscribe to my channel and share this video. Love you.